Good morning, students. Today we are going to start with the 11th chapter in grammar, that is modals. Modals or modal auxiliaries are the verbs which are used before ordinary verb to express permission, possibility, ability, obligation, suggestion, request, and so on. They indicate the attitude, intention, and mood of the parents. Modals or auxiliary verbs, they are used in a sentence before the main verb. Yani ki modals ya to auxiliary modals sentence mein verb ke pehle use kiye jate hai. So hum unhe helping verbs bhi keh sakte hai. Modals sentence mein jo action yani kriya hoti hai usmein ability, obligation, advice, suggestion ya to permission ko express karte hai. Alag alag purpose ke liye अलग अलग मॉडल ऑक्सिलरीज यूज़ किए जाते हैं सेंटेंस में. अलग अलग एक्शंस सजेस्ट करने के लिए, कहने के लिए, मीनिंग लाने के लिए अलग अलग ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब्स यूज़ किए जाते हैं. या फॉर एग्जांपल, एबिलिटी शो करने के लिए हम कैन, कुड या बी एबल टू यूज़ करते हैं. ऑब्लिगेशन, एडवाइस या तो सजेशन शो करने के लिए वी यूज़ द वर्ड्स शुड, मस्ट या तो ऑट टू बी. एक सेंटेंस में जब हमें परमिशन शो करनी है तब हम मॉडल्स लाइक मे, कैन या तो कुड यूज़ कर सकते हैं. नाउ लेट अस सी द मेन फीचर्स ऑफ यूजिंग अ मॉडल इन अ सेंटेंस, हाउ टू यूज़ इट. हर एक सेंटेंस में मॉडल के बाद हमेशा मेन वर्ब तो आता ही है, क्योंकि मेन वर्ब ही हमें एक्शन शो करता है. सो लेट अस सी एन एग्जांपल. ही शुड विजिट हिज ग्रैंडमदर रेगुलरली. सो यहाँ हम देखेंगे तो मॉडल इसमें क्या है. सो व्हाट वी सेड के शुड के बाद मेन वर्ब आना ही चाहिए. सो व्हाट इज द मेन वर्ब हियर? विजिट. सो इट इज, वी कैन सी हियर कि मॉडल के बाद मेन वर्ब आता ही है. ही शुड विजिट हिज ग्रैंड मदर रेगुलरली. सो हियर द मॉडल ऑक्सिलरी इज शुड एंड द मेन वर्ब इज विजिट विच कम्स आफ्टर द ऑक्सिलरी वर्ब. नाउ द सेकेंड फीचर इज क्वेश्चन टैग्स. इन क्वेश्चन टैग्स मॉडल्स कैन बी यूज्ड अलोन. फॉर एग्जांपल, यू कैन मेक एन एप्पल पाई, कांट यू? सो हियर वी सी दैट कांट यू, इट इज अ क्वेश्चन टैग. इट हैज बीन यूज्ड, दोज वर्ड्स आर बीन यूज्ड टू मेक अ क्वेश्चन टैग. सो हियर वी कैन से दो द वर्ड मेक इज अ मॉडल हियर, बट आफ्टर द वर्ड कांट यू विच इज यूज्ड फॉर मॉडल वी हैव नॉट यूज्ड द मेन वर्ब. सो वी कैन यूज अ मॉडल इन क्वेश्चन टैग्स अलोन. वी कैन यूज द मॉडल अलोन. नाउ द थर्ड फीचर इज मॉडल्स आर नॉट अफेक्टेड बाई चेंज इन द पर्सन, दैट इज फर्स्ट पर्सन, सेकेंड पर्सन, थर्ड पर्सन or number, that is singular or plural, of the subject. Now let us see the example. He may come, that is a sentence in the singular form, while they may come, that is a sentence in the plural form. So we can say that the modal m may has not changed whether the sentence is in the singular form or in the plural form. In the same way, let us see the example for the persons. I can swim, that is in the first person. You can swim, that is in the second person. She can swim, that is in the third person. So here also we could see that there is no change in the model. It remains the same. The word can is a model here which has remained the same, whether the sentence is in the first person, second person, or so we can see that the models are not affected by change in the person or the number of the subject. Now the next feature is sentence mein model ke baad jo main verb use hota hai wo verb ka root yani ki main form hi hona chahiye. Present participle ya past participle use nahi ho sakte. So let us see the example. Could you come here early? So here in this sentence the word could is a model. So if we see the verb come, it is the main form of the verb. We cannot use the present participle or past participle. We cannot use the word came here. So it shows that we need to use the main root of the verb after using any model. Now let us see how different models are used to express different meanings to the sentence, to give different meanings to the different in different ways. First of all, we will see about the models that express ability. The words that express ability are can, could, and be able to. Now the word can, when it is used as a model, it indicates the ability of a person to do something. It means to be able to be capable of, to know. So let us see the sentence and understand it. He can drive the new racing car. He can write with both the hands. So here the sentence tells us about a person's ability to drive the car or the person's ability to use both the hands. So the word can is used, then to the word could is used to suggest ability in the past. Now let us see the example. He could walk for a kilometer without a break. So here it is not clear whether he walked for a kilometer without a break or not. So he may have walked or he may not have walked, but it suggests, could it suggest, he could do it. Whether he has done it or not, it is not sure. So it suggests the ability of the person. And then it also suggests general ability. In my childhood, I could climb tree. That shows that I knew this, how to climb the tree. It was just, it gives us some idea about the past. And be able to indicates ability to do something which is more possible than can. For example, he was able to write with both the hands. Surely we can say that he was able to do it. That means he was ready and he was writing it with both the hands. He wrote with both the hands. So it shows surety of a person more than. Now let us see about the models that are used to show obligation, advice, or suggestion. The words are should, must, and ought to. Now let us see where should is used. Should is used as a model to make suggestion or to give an advice. Let us see the example. You should take the medicine twice daily. That is an advice. So next example is, should we call the police as someone is hiding in the garden? So that is a suggestion. We are suggesting someone, should we do this? So that is, there also should is used as a model. Next, we should eat more vegetables and fruit. So here the word should is used to give suggestion what we should do. Now the word must. Must suggest strong obligation. You must help your friend in need. So it strongly tells us that you must do this. Now, the word must also suggest compulsion and the desire of the speaker. It suggests that you must do it compulsory. When some work is to be done compulsorily, we use the word must. Let us see the example. You must submit your medical report at the head office before joining the company. Now, next example. You must complete your work now. So this is a compulsion. It is an order given to someone. So there we use the word must. Then it suggests the necessity. Example, the government must ensure that people have access to drinking water. Now the word ought to. It conveys a sense of moral duty. Let us see the example. You ought to plant trees to save the environment. You should do this. So it is our duty. It suggests us about our duty. It also suggests that it is the right thing to do. What something we should do. It is right to do this. Let us see the example. You ought to avoid oily food as you have a heart problem. So whenever you have a heart problem, you should do this. If you want to do it or not, it is up to you. So it suggests that this is the right thing. Now, let us see the modal words that are used to express permission. The words are may, can, could. Now, how they are used? The word may suggests permission, which is formal in nature and polite. May I drink water? When we ask for the permission to drink water, there we use the word may. May I drink water? So we ask it in a polite way or a formal way. So there, for formality, we use the modal word may. You may come in. So that is also where we use may. The word can, it suggests permission, which is less than formal than may. Can is informal. Can I borrow your pen? So here, you ask something in an informal way, not in a formal way. In that case, we use the word can. Can I borrow your pen? So you're asking for a permission for in an informal way. Now the word could is used as a model in a sentence to suggest permission in the past. Let us see the example. He told me I could leave. So when the permission is given in the past and we are talking it in right now, then we use the word could. And it is used more polite than may. Sir, could you grant me leave on Saturday? We saw that in the word may, we are asking politely. But here it is something more than polite. So there we use the word could as a model. Sir, could you grant me leave on Saturday? So this is how the different models are used to express different meaning in a sentence.